Since the very early days of solar cells, people have always pondered upon this question that what is the maximum efficiency that you can get for this solar energy conversion? And previously I was mentioning to you this Shockley-Coiler limit, which gives a maximum ceiling of energy conversion of around 32% if you have a single junction solar cells. But we saw that if you increase the concentration of sunlight, then you can further increase this such that you can go higher than this 32% and you can achieve energy conversion of around 42%. Similarly, if you use more junctions, if for example if you use a 2 junction or a 3 junction or a 4 junction based solar cell, you can get efficiencies of 42% or 48% or going even higher and higher efficiencies. So the fundamental question that I need to still answer is, what is the fundamental limit on this efficiency conversion, or what is the maximum efficiency I can get by using any solar cell or any other, or even, you know, let's not just restrict ourselves to just a solar cell, but by any converter which converts this energy coming from the sun into a useful form of work. So I turn to something more fundamental to answer this very pertinent question, and I turn to my simple laws of thermodynamics to help me find out what is the maximum efficiency for this solar conversion process. So I can associate this energy conversion in terms of some energy fluxes and fluxes of work and entropy and so on. So let me start by drawing this red arrow, which represents the energy flux coming from the sun, and I'll represent that using this symbol. So what I'm interested then is finding out how much of this energy I can convert into a useful form of work, which I'll denote by this color green. So my efficiency then, which is represented often by this Greek symbol eta, which looks like a funny form of n, is this efficiency is essentially nothing but this this work divided by the energy flux coming from the sun. So you might ask yourself, you know, what is the maximum efficiency by which you can convert this energy from the sun into this useful form of work? Can it be 100%? And the answer to that is no. And the reason is the second law of thermodynamics. So far I've considered only energy, but what with this energy is associated entropy flux. So I'll represent that in this color blue. And this entropy flux is at minimum given by this formula, whereas this energy flux divided by the temperature, in this case the temperature of the sun. So now my second law of thermodynamics states that whenever I'm doing this energy conversion, there must be a net generation of entropy which is taking place in this process, and I must balance out this entropy fluxes of my incoming entropy and my generated entropy, and that must give me the entropy flux which is going out. So what it says is that whenever I'm doing this this conversion process, there must be an entropy generation which is taking place. So there must be an entropy which is generated in this conversion, and this must be always a greater or equal to zero. So now I have this incoming energy which has this associated entropy flux, and I have this entropy generation. So I must also have outgoing outgoing flux of entropy associated, and that mandates that I release some of this energy which was coming from the sun into a form of heat, and I represent that by the symbol Q. And the corresponding entropy flux that would be associated with that can be represented by the skew divided by the temperature, and in this case the temperature of the ambient in which this heat is being released out. So I can restate these two laws of thermodynamics more mathematically, and I can use that to calculate this maximum efficiency that I'll get from this energy that I can get from this process. So let me write down the first law of thermodynamics, which basically says that energy is conserved. Whenever you have this conversion, the net energy is always conserved. And the way I can state that mathematically is that this energy flux, which is coming from the sun, must be equal to the amount of work that I'm generating, or this flux of work, plus the amount of heat that I'm releasing out, or the flux of heat that I'm releasing out. So that is my first law of thermodynamics, which which deals with energy conservation. Now I also have the second law of thermodynamics, which deals with the conservation of these entropy fluxes. So what I have, my incoming flux of entropy is essentially given by this formula, plus the entropy which is generated in the process, this entropy flux which is generated during this energy conversion must be equal to the net entropy flux which is going out, and that is given by this formula. So now I'm interested in finding out the maximum value of this efficiency, and I can take these two equations from the first and second law of thermodynamics and input and plug it into this equation. So I can substitute, for example, work flux from this equation, and I can write it as my ES minus Q, and this is divided by ES again. So my maximum efficiency is essentially looks like it's given by this formula. So to maximize my efficiency, I need to minimize this term, which is being subtracted from heat, which was subtracted from it. So I need to minimize my amount of heat generation. So now let me make use of the second law of thermodynamics. And to get this equation, I'll multiply both the left hand side and the right hand side by ES, and that gives me this term Q by ES over here, and SG by ES over here, and then ES cancels out from here. And then I'll take the temperature of the ambient temperature on, so I'll multiply the whole equation by TA as well, and that will essentially multiply this whole thing by TA. So now I get my Q by ES is essentially equal to, it's equal to TA by TS plus SG times TA by ES. So now this would be, I want to find the minimum value of this, because that would maximize my efficiency. So the minimum value of this would be when this entropy which is generated in this energy conversion must be equal to zero. So this thing would be minimum if SG is equal to zero. And the minimum value of this was equal to TA by TS. So that correspondingly gives me a maximum value for the efficiency, and the maximum value of efficiency that I can get is 1 minus QS by ES, which essentially translates into TA by TS. And this is what is also known as the Carnot efficiency limit, or the efficiency of Carnot engine. And if you have studied about engines, then you might be familiar with this efficiency limit. It's spelled as Carnot, but it's pronounced as Carnot. This T over here is silent, and that's because this Carnot was a French person. So this is Carnot efficiency. And for our case, where the temperature of the ambient, we can assume it to be around 300 Kelvin, And I can assume the sun to be a black body at around 6000 Kelvin. And in that case, this Carnot efficiency is given by approximately 95%. So according to this Carnot efficiency limit, we can convert 95% of the energy coming from the sun into a form of useful work, which could be electricity. But I'll show in the next video that this is never possible for this solar energy conversion process. So see you in the next video.